गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, एज यू नो दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, इन दैट लेट अस मूव टुवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज वैलेंसी. वैलेंसी इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ कंबाइनिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ एन एलिमेंट, और इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रेजेंट इन द आउटरमोस्ट शेल ऑफ एन एटम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एनी ऑफ द एलिमेंट वेन इट शेयर इट विल बी इट्स वैलेंसी, और the number of electrons present in the outermost shell, then it will be its valency. So for example let us take sodium, okay, Na, whose atomic number 11, and its EC will become 281. So 1 is the electron which is present in the outermost shell, so its valency will become 1. For example, carbon, atomic number 6, its EC will become 24. Here 4 is its valency, means it will require 4 for if you want to complete its valency, then it will gain 4 electron or it will lose 4 electron. For example, hydrogen, its atomic number 1, so its EC will become 1. And any time when they form any of the ion or any of the compound, at that time they will gain the electron or they will share the electron. They will gain the electron or they will lose the electron. And at that time their valency will be decided. For example, that is methane. Okay. In methane, this carbon atom having 4 valence electron. Okay. And hydrogen, it having only 1 valence electron. When carbon is combining with hydrogen, then its valency will become 4. Because hydrogen having 1 electron, okay, and it required only 1 electron. When the carbon of its 1 electron, it will given to hydrogen, so its valency will become complete. Here this carbon, when the second lone pair or a single loosely electron, it will shared by this hydrogen, then this hydrogen's valency will get satisfied. Then again the third hydrogen, when this one carbon electron, it will shared with this hydrogen atom, its valency will get shared. And now remaining the fourth hydrogen, when one carbon electron is shared with this hydrogen electron, then the valence of this hydrogen atom is also completed. In the same way, carbon having 4 valence electron, for being stable it required more 4 electrons. So what the carbon will do? Carbon having 1 2 3 4 valence electron, and when it will gain 4 hydrogen atoms electrons, then the valency of the carbon also get completed and hydrogen also get completed, and then the new molecule of methane, it will get formed. And because of this only, the valency of any of the element, it will get decided. Now let us take one more example, magnesium chloride. Okay, in magnesium chloride, the atomic number of magnesium is 12. Its EC will become 282. As well as chlorine, its atomic number 17, its EC will become 287. Okay, now here this magnesium atom, for being stable, it will try to lose 2 electrons, to donate 2 electrons. So when these 2 atoms of magnesium, it will get combined with chlorine, so its valency will become 2. Okay, for example, this will like this, this Mg, it having 2 electrons which he want to donate, and this chlorine, it having 7 already with him. So this 1, it will come here. Here again the chlorine, this 1 will come here. So the valency of chlorine is also get satisfied by 8 electron, and here the valency of this chlorine also get satisfied. And magnesium, when it lose 2 electron, its new EC will become 28, and it will carry plus 2 charge. So in this way, the valency of chlorine and magnesium both will get satisfied. Let us take one more example, magnesium oxide. Magnesium oxide, where magnesium, it want to lose 2 electrons, and oxygen, when one atom of oxygen combines with magnesium, so its valency, it will become double. Why? Because magnesium, it want to lose 2 electrons, and oxygen, when it gains 2 electrons, when it gains 2 electrons from magnesium, then its valency will become double, and hence its valency will become 2. Okay, Now let us move towards another point, valency of metal as well as non-metal. Valency of a metal is the number of electron lose by any of the atom during the formation of a compound that will become its valency. For example, valency of potassium will be 1, valency of sodium is also 1, valency of magnesium it will become 2. In the same way, in the non-metal, the valency of a non-metal is the number of electron which is gained by that atom, it will become its valency. For example, chlorine, just now we have seen in magnesium chloride, where chlorine will get 1 electron, so its valency will become 1. Sulfur will get 2 electrons, so its valency will become 2. Now, in the metal, there are some more terms. Monovalent element or electron, sorry. So, the element which having valency 1, or they will donate 1 electron, then they are called as monovalent elements. Sodium, potassium are the example of monovalent. One more time I am repeating, those element whose valency will be 1, they are monovalent. Those element which having valency 2, they are called as divalent. Oxygen, magnesium are the divalent element. Trivalent, the element which having valency 3, for example, nitrogen, phosphorus. Tetravalent element, the element which having valency 4, they are called as tetravalent. For example, carbon, platinum. Okay, up to this we have completed the first point. Now the next is variable valency. Now children, some element, not all, but some element, they show more than one valency. Okay, in a different compounds. Such elements are called as, variable valency. Those element which show the valency, more than one valency, in a different compound, they are called as, they possess variable valency. For example, this ferrous oxide, where valency is 2, valency of iron is 2, and ferrous trioxide, where valency of iron is 3. Where the valency is less, like 2, it will be known as ferric, ferric, and where valency is more, then it will be ferrous. Okay, so there is a difference when we name them ferric and ferrous. Okay, so today we will stop here only. In the next period we will move towards another point, that is radical. Good day, children.